In my attempt to simply replace the felt wipers on a Bridgeport while adjusting the gib, little did I know that my Y-axis gib was so worn that as I screwed in the gib, I also was pushing the gib past the saddle, and because I installed the cover on the rear side of the saddle, I ended up snapping the aluminum felt cover. Before any new covers have to be put on, I actually have to adjust the gib so it doesn't protrude in the saddle. And the way that we're going to do this is that we're going to add some shims to the back of the gib. This is the non-contact slide of the gib, so this is not going to make contact with the dovetail. This is simply just going to take up space within that area and prevent the gib from going back farther when we are just simply trying to make an adjustment. We've had to make the adjustment on the gib about three times. So we've got a 2000s stainless steel shim, and we test fitted, then we checked for play in the table, and then we added additional shims, actually gluing them in place, which should hold up just fine until we were able to get the desired movement of the gib, basically meaning not to protrude in the back of the saddle, as well as getting the tightness that we need on the table from actually moving it. So we have just the right adjustment, and we finished that off with a total of 6,000s worth of shims on this Y-axis gib. With the gib back installed into the machine, we've almost got it just flush with the front saddle, whereas before we were about maybe 3/4 of an inch deep, and that's what caused us to break through. Time to finally install the 3D printed felt covers. These took a little bit of trial and error to get just right, but now that we have them, we've got the right amount of squeeze on the felt, and we have the just the right amount of pressure that we like, where the felt is actually wiping everything, and it looks like I'm gonna keep these on the machine for the long term. Thanks for watching this video.